discussing dialogue writing, which is again a topic in the writing section of English. Now, dialogue writing, the word dialogue has been derived from the word dialogos. It has been derived from the word dialogos. Now, this dialogos is basically a Greek word which is made from two words, dia plus logos, where dia means two and logos means speech or conversation. So from the two meanings, we are clear that dialogue is basically a conversation, or it is a speech between two people, or it can be among more than two persons. So the definition can be that it is basically a conversation. It is a conversation between two or more people, in which they can express their views. First point is, they can express their views or they can form a simple greeting, or one person can ask questions to the other person. So we can say they can ask questions or put a point of argumentation. So they can put a point of argumentation . So these are some of the ways in which the dialogues can be exchanged between two people or more than two people. Either they can greet, they can ask questions, they can argue, they can express their views, or just a simple discussion. And a discussion will always take place only when you argue, you ask questions, or you express your views. One person will express the view, other might contradict that view or also favor the view. So accordingly, a dialogue is exchanged between the two people. Now dialogue writing is very important part in the areas. It is an important tool in the areas where dialogues are exchanged. Dialogues are basically exchanged in novels, in dramas, in poems. And why do we actually make use of dialogue writing? So that we can make it look more real, right? Some kind of reality takes place and it helps us to express more. So we use dialogue writing in novels, dramas and poems in order to make it more real and to enhance the look of my drama or to enhance the meaning of my poem. So for that reasons, I make use of dialogue writing. Now, like I said, that dialogue writing is a part of writing section. Now, not only dialogue writing, any topic of writing section, be it letter writing or notice or speech or article, anything is very important, because here the examiner asks you these questions in order to analyze your imagination power and your creativity. So even in dialogue writing, when there is a question arised, it is very important that you use good vocabulary in order to write the dialogues, so that the examiner actually comes to know how efficient you are in your English. So now we will be understanding dialogue writing through an example. I will be presenting a question before you, and then accordingly we have to form a dialogue that can occur between two people or more than two people. That depends upon the question which is asked. So let us have a look at the question. Now this is the question of dialogue writing, which is provided in the content section. So when you click on the dialogue writing in your content section, the same question will be present over there along with the accurate answers in order to complete your dialogue. So here I can see that my dialogue is incomplete because there are blanks provided over here, and here our task is to fill in those blanks. Now in order to fill those blanks, these are the hints that are provided for each of the four blanks. There are four hints. Now here, this is a dialogue writing cum rearrangement of sentences. Here my sentences are in jumbled form. I need to correct those sentences and then I need to make sure that which sentence would be fit in which particular blank. So here now let us have a look at the conversation. Here the conversation or the exchange of dialogue is between Mr. Arun and Mr. Kumar. Here Arun says, "Good morning, Mr. Kumar," and Kumar says, "Hello, how can I help you?" Arun says, "I'm not sure," and then there's a blank. Kumar says, "Have you any idea about what would you like to do?" Arun says, "I want to become a journalist," so again there's a blank. Kumar says, "What do your parents want you to study?" To which Arun replies, "Science." They, and again there's a blank. Then Kumar says, "What would happen if you take science?" And then Arun, there's again a blank. So now from the dialogue we know that the conversation is between Arun and Mr. Kumar, and here Arun is asking for suggestions from Mr. Kumar as to what he would pursue in future so that he can have a bright future. Now again there are jumbled sentences. Here first what do we need to do over here? Before coming to dialogue writing, we should first arrange our sentences. The first sentence is, "Can help, how you I." Now if you look correctly, there can be a sentence like, "How can I help you?" So this is the correct formation of sentence. I will say, "How can I help you?" This is the sentence which is correctly formed. Earlier the sentence was in jumbled form. Now I have made my correct formation of sentence. Next it says, "If will I take furious don't signs be." So here I can say that if I don't, no. Now here also make sure that this sentence has connection with so or they, right? So accordingly I have to form a sentence, and my sentence will be, "Will be furious if I don't take signs." So the correct formation of a sentence B is this. Now C says, "Would I expect fail I miserably?" Here the you have to keep on reading the sentence in order to find out the correct formation. Again, this is just a hit and try. If I say, "I fail, I would expect miserably," that is wrong. But if I say, "I expect, I would fail miserably," this is the correct formation. So, through hit and trial, I will get the correct formation of my sentence. I say, "I expect, I would fail miserably," and the D part is, "Here to ask I'm your advice." I think this is the most easy sentence of jumble. I will say, "I am here to ask your advice." Now over here, I have removed all the jumbled sentences and formed the correct sentence. Now, out of all these sentences, I have to make sure that which blank is suitable for which sentence. So now let us take a look on the first blank. The first blank is I am not sure dash after SSCE. So the correct sentence out of all these will be which course should I take? So this will be my first blank, that I am not sure which course should I take after SSCE, right? This is done. Next is Mr. Kumar says, have you any idea what would you like to do? To which Arun replies, I want to be a journalist. So, dash. Now here, so how can I help you? No. So, will be furious? No. So, I expect I would fail miserably? No. So, I am here to ask your advice? Right. So, this will be my second blank. So, I am here to ask your advice. Next it says, what do your parents want you to study? Arun says, science. They, and again, blank. They, how can I help you? Wrong. Will be furious if I don't take science? Yes, kind of matches the sentence. So now B, this is my third blank. This sentence fixes my third blank, right? Next is, what would happen if you take science? To which Arun replies, now this is done, this is done, this is done. Left is, I expect I would fail miserably, and this will be my fourth sentence. How can I help you? It is already over here. So, here my sentence will be, I expect I would fail miserably, and through this I have completed my dialogue writing. Now, the dialogues between Arun and Mr. Kumar are completed, and hence this is the example of dialogue writing. Now, here I have made a video on the same question. If you want to have a look at the same question, you can visit the content section. So, in this video, we have talked about dialogue writing. Dialogue writing is a conversation between two or more people. Here, it is a conversation between Arun and Mr. Kumar. We've also understood the concept of jumbled sentences. So, here I have covered jumbled sentences as well as dialogue writing. So, my suggestion to you is that this is just one example of dialogue writing. Keep on practicing, keep on learning in order to become master in English. Till then, thank you.